and we're definitely looking to create more revenue in the water department. And my thinking was the city and the water department are partners. And if the water department's making more money, the city and the water department could team up and they could help us with some of our problems and we could help them with some of their problems. One of the ideas that we talked about early on was, how much is the Hammond Water Department worth? You know, if a company like Indiana American Water purchased it, or if it's a hedge fund that purchased it, or if it's Chinese investors that purchased it, or if it's NIPSCO that purchased it, or, you know, some other utility, how much is it worth on the open market? My thinking was, I pay attention to what's going on downstate, and the mayor of Indianapolis just recently sold his water company for $425 million. And I'm thinking, wow, if I could, and he has to sell all of his water to wholesale customers in Indiana, which means the IURC regulates their money. If I could sell wholesale water to Illinois at any rate, and we all know because of what Mayor Emanuel's done, that the water rates are extremely high in Illinois right now, I could sell our water in Illinois at a much higher price than Mayor Ballard's water company could sell to Indiana customers. So what's ours worth? You know, we got some quotes that said ours is only worth a couple hundred million. We have a couple quotes that said it was worth a lot more than 400 million. You know, and the only way for us to find out exactly how much it would have been worth would be go through a legal process that would have, we would have huge, huge legal bills. And, you know, I'm talking, you know, think about it, Jim, you're in the market, you know, if you're
just
talking.
Just to find out what something's worth and see if you can put out a, just some, even if it's quiet, things. And I get these from time to time. Oh, that's, I mean, just even on small businesses, it's like $100,000, right?
And we're
there,
talking
man.
About a $300-400 million merger.
You're talking a big
check. Numbers. And I'm talking to great lawyers that know what they're doing. In fact, I talked to the lawyers that did the Indianapolis deal. The law firm of Baker and Daniels was helping us on this, and we were starting to see some of the bills come in, and we were asking, you know, what could we expect? Because I have to go back to the taxpayers and justify to them, if I'm getting $1 million legal bills, I have to explain it to the residents why we're paying huge money to Baker and Daniels. And it was really uncomfortable. And I know the employees of the water department were really uncomfortable, and they're great people. I mean, the water department employees have been wonderful to me all the way through. And I've reassured them all the way through that we're not ever going to make a deal where they're going to lose their job. I'm going to either personally watch out for them, or they're going to be absorbed by the new company. And it just, about 2 or 3 weeks ago, we all got together. We have regular meetings on the water topic now. It's like a weekly standing meeting. And we got together and we said, guys, I think we need to shift gears here. You know, who knows? 20 years from now, Hammond Water Department, if it was worth $400 million now, it could be worth $2 billion 20 years from now. Who knows?
But getting back to that, can't you still, I mean, not act as a private company, but you can still sell your water to the folks on the south side,
and
right?
We do, and we're lucky that this year the contracts with Calumet City and Chicago Heights are both up, and these are long-term contracts, 20-year deals. In fact, Chicago Heights was a 30-year deal. Chicago Heights has been paying about 60 cents per 1,000 gallons for the last 30 years, and the current market price, Chicago's charging their customer communities $2.50 for the same amount of water. So Chicago Heights is going to see an increase in their water rates. And we're going to make it so that they're getting a better deal than Chicago water customers are getting. But to say that Chicago Heights is going to continue to pay 60 cents is not true. Same goes for Cal City. I mean, you will see an increase in your water rates in Cal City and in Chicago Heights one way or another. You're either going to be a customer of the Hammond Water Department, or you're going to be a customer of Mayor Emanuel, who's charging a lot more than we are. But the bottom line is, the increase in contract prices that we're going to negotiate is going to increase the revenue to the city of Hammond and to the water department. And what we're doing is partnering with the water department. So I think relief is on the way to the Hammond City budget, and I'm happy about that. And you know, we still have options, you know, as far as, you know, revenue stream options, if we choose to go down that route, or we could just, you know, there's still a couple options. But what we announced during Mayor's Night the other day was, as far as privatization, selling the water department, that's off the table. We're not even considering that anymore. We're looking more to maximize our opportunities. So
219-845-1100 if you want to talk to Hammond Maritime McDermott. It is 802 in the Calumet region, which means I have to tell you that we are listening to AM 1230 WJOB in Hammond, Indiana. Let's go to Bob on line one.
Hey, Bob, how's it going?
Good, Mayor. I had a question about the water.
Sure.
When is the soonest we can start selling it to Illinois, and is it an infrastructure thing or is it a legality thing?
Great question. Now, we've been selling water to Illinois. We have three different taps in Illinois. The first is in Cal City, and Cal City takes that water and they forward it to, I forgot which community, but maybe it's Burnham. Cal City and gets water from us. That's one of our taps in Illinois. The second tap in Illinois is in Lansing, and they're, I think they are a terminal, meaning they don't forward that water. They just use it there. And then the third tap is a pipeline that was built 30 years ago down to Chicago Heights. And from Chicago Heights, they branch out into another couple communities. In fact, if we want to expand our presence in Illinois, it's going to be through Chicago Heights, because they have a lot of potential for us to branch out into other communities that we can't touch. So we've been selling water to Illinois. But the thing is, Bob, we've been selling water to Illinois on long-term contracts, 20, 30-year contracts at low rates. Now, 30 years ago when the mayors made these deals, I'm not sure, you know, why the mayors and the water department gave Cal City, Chicago Heights, and Lansing residents the same water rates that we charge Hammond residents when it's our money that pays for the filtration plant and the employees. It just doesn't make a lot of sense. So
absolutely,
what we're going to do is change that. What I'm going to do and the water department, we're going to make sure that that's not going to happen anymore. And I'm going to tell you, Bob, you're a Hammond resident, I imagine, right?
Yes.
And, you know, what we do, we're limited in Indiana. So I sell water to Munster. We sell water to Munster, Hammond Water Department, okay? We sell it to Munster for around 50, 60 cents per 1,000 gallons, okay? We have to sell it at that rate because the IARC limits us on what we could sell it for. Munster is not a wholesaler anymore. Once they buy their water, what they do is they take our water at 60 cents per 1,000 gallons and they sell it to their residents for $3 per 1,000 gallons. So the IARC limits me on what I could sell it to Munster for, but Munster could charge 20 bucks for the same water I sold it to them for 60 cents. And they're not. They're selling it at $3 right now. And they're using our water to pad Munster's budget. That's not fair. And quite frankly, it makes me not want to sell water at all to Indiana because it doesn't make sense. We want to sell our water in Illinois now.
So if we start selling it to Illinois at a huge profit, is that profit going to go to the water department or will it go to the Hammond budget where we can take care of our budget shortfalls?
Great question, Bob.
Thanks a lot, Bob.
That's a great question that Bob just asked, and that's exactly what we're working through right now. So that was a great phone call, and Bob seems like he's really on top of things. So, and Bob, that's exactly what we're working on, is what type of deal can the water department make with the city of Hammond so that obviously the water department needs that revenue as well so that they can maintain the infrastructure and the personnel. But at the same time, you know, the city is what gave birth to the water department in the first place. So great phone call.